Vaya tu tío.
Isaac Silver.
Make or prepare on the vision statement of Sunrise Andhra Pradesh to find two core individuals, entrepreneurial capital of India. So the recommendation I would say, like in the West, primarily, most of is one of the great team. I think you are also having technology business incubator. You are mentoring the entrepreneurs. It's the combination of knowledge and practice. So, I mean, with this brief.
Other panelists, distinguished invited. Our students are girl students on the campus. And this report are. But today,
who have made at least us to stand here today.
May I request Sri Shivarao Tumbalapalli ji to give us a token of our appreciation. Now it's a tea break. May I request all the participants to please join for the tea. And exactly, we'll be joining here at 11:30.
11:30.
Now
time is 11:30.
Vice Chancellor Andhra University to kindly deliver his
inaugural.
To girl students, everybody.
Culture of men also participating in the process of childcare. We see this a lot. Good. Thank you
so much, Kajal. May I request?
In the same way, look at Indra Nui, a similar.
And last but not the least, I think I need to acknowledge the company that I belong to, which is Heritage Foods, because of which I think I become eligible to be here and to contribute as well. The theme of today's workshop of women entrepreneurship and boardroom diversity is, it comes at a very good time. India is talking about its budget. We've spoken about the growth that we've seen in the 3 years, starting 2014. We've seen a GDP growth rate of 7.5%, which is one of the highest in the world. We're also talking about all this at a time that India has shown an improvement in ranking of ease of doing business from 130 to 100, which I think is a great achievement. But all these achievements will only be sustainable if women are included in the process of growing the country, growing the economy, and contributing towards entrepreneurship. If all of you have taken the time to be here and to learn, it means that there is interest from women to go to the next level. As mentioned by one of the guests earlier, India has a very strong legacy of women leaders, be it Ms. Indra Nooyi at PepsiCo, or be it Indian women leading Indian organizations itself, especially in financial services. We all are there to achieve really high goals and to go to the next level. According to the International Monetary Fund, raising women's labor force participation to that of men can contribute significantly towards the GDP of a country, to 9% when it comes to a developed nation like Japan, and to as high as 27% when it comes to a country like India. Now, I'm not saying we need to achieve a number as high. Even if we achieve 50% of that, you can imagine how much benefit will come to our country when it comes to growth. It also leads to a lot of macroeconomic improvement. Like, for instance, a lot of research so shows that women's involvement in boards will bring in better corporate governance. It will bring in better monitoring. It will drive companies and organizations towards more sustainable growth. And hence, I think facts also prove that women participation is extremely important in when it comes to governance, especially among men. The representation of women in boards is still very low. Sometimes they can be lone voices. In my case, we are two women on the board of our company. And in very, very few cases, you see three women or more in boards of companies in India. Clearly, all stakeholders, be it governments, be it regulatory bodies like SEBI in India, be it professional organizations like the Institute of Directors, and most importantly, all of us, we all aspire to improve women's participation when it comes to boardrooms as well as entrepreneurship.